So anything that you can imagine, or even things that you can't imagine, it's here at Maker Faire. Check this out. I think I'm about to be eaten by some, like, lawnmower on steroids. I don't know what it is. Quite honestly, I don't know what it does, but I'd love to have one. This had to be a blast to create. We gotta dig up the maker of this puppy. This blows the snapper lawnmowers completely out of the water. Not only can you mow your lawn, you can flatten the hell out of it with this thing. So tell me about this. What is it? Some kind of revolutionary new lawnmower?
No, this is just, this is art on tracks.
Art on tracks.
Fire sculpture robot.
A fire sculpture robot. And it's got to weigh at least 40, 50 pounds?
About 30 pounds, yeah. No, she weighs about 2,000 pounds. Just a electric hydraulic steel tracks. Used to be an asphalt paving machine. Yeah, two 10-gallon propane tanks, a 15-gallon methanol tank. She's got four 100-amp-hour batteries. She's got about a half an hour runtime. That's about it, really.
And you just knocked this out in an afternoon? What?
I built this robot in a month.
Oh, my God.
From scratch. The tracks were actually 10 feet wide when I got them. I had to torch cut them in half and narrow them down so they would fit this narrower platform that I wanted. So, yeah, about a month, 30 days.
This is awesome. And what's its name?
This is Libby.
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 You know, it kind of resembles a Libby.
Yeah?
You know? Well. Yeah. I think I used to date a girl that looked like this. She had a long, kind of pointy nose, and she was heavy. So.
Crushed you?
Crushed me, yeah. She broke my heart, stepped on me, molded me into the ground. This could probably do the same thing.
Do this too. She will flatten you out and splay you out, and just like most women.
And you've got an assortment here. This is Libby's cousin. What is this?
This is Charlie. This is Charlie the Turbine Robot. It's a series hybrid with a jet engine that powers the electric drive systems.
A jet engine?
A jet engine, yes. It's a Solar T6216. It's the smallest jet engine that the Solar company makes. It powers a DC generator right here, and the DC generator charges the batteries down deep inside the machine, and the batteries drive the tracks. So it's an electric robot fire sculpture
with a jet engine.
With a jet engine.
I gotta say that again, with a jet engine. One more time. It's got a jet engine in it.
It does have a jet engine.
It's not good enough to make just a robot that weighs, what, a couple tons?
This robot weighs about 1,200 pounds.
1,200 pounds with a jet engine. So, how fast will it go?
This robot goes about 15 miles an hour.
That's fast.
If I turned it on and put it into a spin right now, it would throw you about into the grass over there.
So, don't jack with this robot. Again, the name of this robot?
This one's Charlie.
Charlie.
Yeah. We don't give the robots complicated names because they're already pretty damn complicated.
Complicated,
yeah.
As they are. Okay. So who else is in the cast of characters here?
This is Darwin. This is Darwin, one of my fire sculpture robots. And Darwin, actually, we will be working on Darwin tomorrow to get Darwin running because Darwin is missing some motor controllers. And it's another fire sculpture robot. It's got a blower right here. And the blower forces air into here and shoots a little fire out of there. This robot is extremely fast, 20 miles an hour probably, on tracks. Can drive over and up anything you put in its way. Yeah. This robot was one of my earlier pieces of robotic work. It took me about a year to build it, start to finish. So it started with a couple of prototypes that were not successful and don't exist anymore.
It
so
just didn't happen.
Didn't pan out, didn't, as they say. So yeah, that's Charlie, and we call this guy Chefley.
Chefley?
Chefley.
Chefley.
Chefley, belonging to the guy over there, Evan, who built this robot. It's got four high-powered gear motors driving it, so it's actually four-wheel drive. You can see the four wheels are independently driven by independent gear motors. It's got enough power and torque to haul around about 500 pounds of weight if you want, but it also is a fire sculpture, and it takes a 10-gallon propane tank. Inside here and makes fire out the front and drives around and generally very playful and fast. Very fast.
So, propane tank mounted on top of a series of batteries.
Yep.
They probably don't spark, so we don't have to worry about the propane tank blowing up.
Okay.
No, we're actually trained professionals. We do this for a living. This is, the robots are the fun, the more fun, playful area of our company, Therm. We do performance fire sculpture, flame effects for events and movies and theater or whatever fire element you need for your party or whatever.
So in other words, don't do this at home.
Yeah, don't try this at home, please.
This is awesome. I'm blown away with the jet engine. I gotta have one of those. Are you gonna be able to make me one for next week?
I take commissions.
There you go.
Take a month.
I'll give you a deposit today.
Sure.
Okay.
I take cash only.
I would.
Or endless credit cards, whatever you choose.
Again, the Maker's Faire. If you can't imagine it, it's here. If you can't imagine it, that's here too.